ChatGPT can actually write good CSS. Yes, you heard that right. I actually believe that, and I actually tried it out quite a few times to see if I can convince it, or rather instruct it, to write good quality CSS, and the results are surprising. Well, as you expect, they're not the best. ChatGPT is not intelligent, so it can't really understand what it does, but it can figure out, based on its dataset, how to actually create code that is good enough, at least in my opinion, that can serve as a baseline for something more. And Kevin Powell actually did a fantastic video on ChatGPT and its ability to write CSS, and I strongly recommend you watch this video and to subscribe to Kevin's channel, because he really does fantastic stuff, as you probably already know. In any case, Kevin outlined all the problems with ChatGPT and its ability to write code, so I'm not gonna go into that in this particular video. I will just focus on a different aspect, and I will just try to see if I can convince it or instruct it to actually write better CSS than it initially does. So once we get an initial output, I will see what the problems are, and I'll try to instruct it to actually fix those problems, or at least improve them, and the results can be pretty good. They're not consistent, they're nowhere nearly ready for production, but bottom line is that if your instructions are good enough, if you're specific enough, you can actually get something that's really useful. So let's jump into the browser and see how we can improve the quality of the CSS output ChatGPT can give us. Before we go any further, I'd just like to make a few notes. So number one, I will just try to have a simple, nice conversation with the AI. I will not touch the code that I get. I will use it as is, and I will give AI suggestions on how to improve that code, and we'll see what we can get at the end. I already did a couple of test runs, so I know what to expect and how to get a bit better results. And as you probably already know, the better your inputs are, the better results you are gonna get. So the more specific we can be, the better CSS AI can write. So now let's start with a simple request. And my first request is going to be, can you please create HTML and CSS for a landing page for CSS Weekly? The page should have logo, navigation, short description with what the newsletter is about, a subscribe form, and a footer. And there we go. It's not really ideal. There is a number of problems with this code. You can probably pinpoint them very easily, but the general idea is we will try to improve that by giving it more specific instructions, but this is just a starting point that we're gonna use. And now for some reason, we didn't get the entire output. This happens probably because the system is overloaded all the time. So let's just see if we can get the AI to separate HTML and CSS. Could you please separate HTML and CSS? And could you leave out everything except for the body tag for HTML? Because we just want to have everything that's within the body tags so we can paste it directly into CodePen. Let's see what we can get. All right, this is HTML exactly as we wanted, except we didn't really want body tag, but that's fine. CSS Weekly, the beach. Well, that is very curious. Have I made a mistake with my input?
Yeah.
Let's see. CSS Weekly, the beach. I'm not a native English speaker, so this probably just escaped me and I didn't realize before I submitted the question, but we're just gonna go with it. This is gonna be CSS Weekly, the beach landing page. And that's exactly why we have this beautiful beach background image in our CSS. Very nice. All right, I'm gonna immediately copy this code here and paste it here. And I'll just remove the body tag. As you can see, this is not ideal. We want this wrapped in unordered list element. Rest of it seems to be decent. So let's just jump back here. And this again broke down before it finished, unfortunately. In any case, we're just gonna copy this code and let's see what we get without the footer. This is far from ideal in terms of design, but for this particular demo, I will not focus on getting it to improve this design. I will just focus on convincing it to get us good CSS and HTML, or at least as good as we can. So let's go back here. And first, let's try improving our HTML problem here. We want navigation items to be wrapped in unordered list. Can you please wrap the navigation items into unordered list element? Old list element, unordered. And there you go. Okay, this is better. Just copy this without the body tags, paste it here. And now CSS is not updated, so this should break down, or at least not look as it should. So in the next step, we want to remove the body tag from our output and we want to turn this into an image. Can you give me HTML without the body tag? And can you please change the logo div to an image? All right, logo div. to an image. And yes, we can get an image instead of a div. This is a bit better. Now, next thing that I want is I would like to use BAM methodology for this particular demo. So I will just ask AI to rewrite all of this using the BAM methodology. Let's see if it can. Can you please rewrite HTML and CSS using the BAM methodology?
BAM. There we go.
We are getting what we expected. We have a header block with the element nav and list. And then we have a container block and a footer block. So this is pretty much okay. We can copy this. Let's paste it into our HTML. And we can also paste CSS once it's done. Hopefully this time it can finish before it breaks down. But we are getting exactly what we expected. All right, let's see how this looks. And I'm going to paste this here. And I'm going to expand my CSS because I think we are pretty much done with the HTML. Oh, this is a major problem. This button is obviously not accessible. I said that we're not going to be dealing with the design here, but maybe we can still get a little bit better result here. Maybe we can ask AI to add a little bit more color to this design. So let's try this. Can you please improve the design a little bit? Maybe add a little bit of color, maybe some kind of a gradient background. Thanks. Let's see what we got here. Okay, I'm going to paste this in and... well, this is actually worse. Let's ask it to switch text color to black. And let's just see what we can improve next. One thing that I would like to do is I'd like to switch those units, those pixel units, to RAM units. So we will ask it to do that. And we might want to ask it to change colors to HSL format, because I love using HSL format. I think it's really great. And I actually have a guide on using HSL as a color format, or why you should switch to HSL color format. So if you still haven't, please check that out. Link is going to be on the screen and in the description. Okay, so we'll just do in one run. We'll ask it to switch text color, to change pixels to RAM units, and to use HSL color format. Can you please switch pixel units to relative units? Can you also please change the text color to black or almost black? And can you please switch the color formats to HSL? Okay. Well, not all colors have been switched, apparently. We can always ask it to improve that. Margin right to viewport height. AI decided to use viewport height units for everything. And that might make sense somewhere like here, but I'm not sure this is really going to work out in places like this. Margin right is going to be two viewport height units. I think the result of this is going to be really interesting. So, okay, text colors are not changed to black or almost black, unfortunately. So that part didn't work. And we really shouldn't be using viewport height units for everything. So I'm just going to improve on that. Can you please switch viewport height units to RAM units except on the body tag? And there we go. All right, we still have viewport units here, and we get RAM units elsewhere, which is nice. But next, let's improve on that. All colors should please use HSL format, new syntax of HSL format. But this is not a new syntax. We still have commas. New syntax is without commas. And transparency should be with the slash. Yeah, this is not really working. So let's just try it one step at a time. Can you please switch all white keywords in CSS to HSL format? To eat yourself, worm it.
Okay.
All right, and now we are getting somewhere. Let's just say to stop generating. And we're going to update this. Can you also switch HSL format to new syntax without commas? Okay, yeah, this is what we wanted. And this is a lot of work just to get a little bit better quality of CSS, as you can see, and it takes a lot of time for AI to generate all of this. Hopefully with time this will improve and we'll just be able to get the entire output while clicking the button. For now, let's just stick with it and see what we can get at the end. I think we still need to improve colors of our text, because this is going to be nearly white, and we don't really want that. Actually, I'm going to stop generating this now, and let's just ask it to immediately switch that. Can you please change all text colors in color property to almost black, or rather 85% black? And immediately, you see here that we actually got kind of what we asked for, but the thing is, Chat AI is not an intelligent system, so it actually did almost to the word what we asked it to. We actually wanted 85% black, but we got 85% white because the third value here is lightness. So this is going to be almost white again and not almost black. So we might want to ask it specifically to tweak the lightness to 15%. Can you please tweak the lightness in color property to 15%? And we are getting what we expected. Literally, we have 15% of lightness on our color property. Exactly what we asked for. As you see, for a lot of things here, you're going to need to understand how CSS works if you want AI to give you better quality of CSS. But the thing is, it's actually possible. So if you're good with CSS, if you understand at least the basics, maybe AI can actually save you a lot of time writing at least the basics of your layout. And then, of course, once the output is ready, you can tweak it manually, or you can, as we're doing right here, you can ask AI to tweak it for you. And now let's see what we get. This should be decent enough. All right. We're not going to be dealing with design anymore. We're just going to focus on improving the CSS now. Let's ask it to use grid for the main page layout. Can you please use CSS grid for main page layout? And please assume that the parent container is body tag. Because if you remember, in our HTML, we ask it not to include the body tag, and the AI might not understand that we have a parent container for our header, container, and footer. So let's see if this can give us what we expect. Oh. Well, I just wanted it to assume that the parent container is body, not that it tweaks our HTML to include the body, but we're just going to go with that. And even though we didn't ask it to, we actually got an alt text on our logo. So maybe AI actually learned something. In any case, it's good that we got an alt text here. And it seems that this broke down. So I'm just going to try to regenerate this. Oh, and this time we didn't get HTML. Even if you ask exactly the same question, you might get different kind of a response. So if you don't get what you expect on the first run, maybe just try running the same question again, and you might get a little bit better result, and you can work from there. Oh, nice. Now we're using grid template areas. I love that. And I actually have a guide on grid template areas. Link is going to be on the screen and in the description. So thank you so much, ChatGPT, for reminding me that I created a guide on grid template areas. Okay, and now if we copy this, let's see if we didn't break something. This is not what we wanted, of course. We want this main area to stretch as much as possible, while the header and footer only take as much space as necessary. Can you please tweak the grid template so the footer and header take only as much space as necessary? And I intentionally didn't specify exactly what I wanted to do. I want to see if we can figure out that we want to have grid template rows with the auto, one fraction, and auto. And that's exactly what it did here. Wonderful. So you don't necessarily need exact instructions, even though that's pretty much very helpful almost always. You can also just generally say what you want it to do. If you have an understanding how grid works, you're going to be able to do that. And then ChatGPT can probably figure out how to do that, how to deliver on that particular request. All right, there we go. And now we're going to paste this in, and this should look better. Of course, this is nowhere near where we want it to be, especially not in terms of design. But I think that this now gives you pretty much good idea about what is possible. So I believe that even if that's not the case right now, the ChatGPT can actually write good quality CSS, or at least decent enough for you to use it and maybe tweak it. Of course, this is a really simplified example, but maybe you can use it just to create random components, or maybe just to generate HTML and CSS for a random component that you're trying to build. Maybe if you want to do pricing table, you can use ChatGPT to generate basic HTML for a table. Maybe you can use it to generate just the basics of CSS for that. And then you can tweak it and fix any problems that you find either in CSS or HTML. Maybe you can even ask AI to fix some of those problems for you. And I think that This can actually be a really helpful tool, and with time, it probably will be. Will it replace developers? Well, here's a controversial opinion. I truly hope it will, because I believe that our time can be spent much better than writing code or actually turning designs into code. This is something that AI should be able to do more efficiently than we can. And our role maybe then becomes just ensuring that the quality is good enough for production, or maybe just fixing AI's mistakes, or maybe just giving it better instructions so it actually creates code that we can use. I'm really excited to see how this develops in the future and how much smarter or better this becomes at writing CSS or code in general. My name is Zoran Nyambor. Thank you so much for watching. I will see and hear you in the next AI system, or rather in the next video.